Good morning. It's 7:53 a.m. Central Time. It's March 13, 2013. It's Wednesday. I started growing my seeds here about a week and a half ago or so. They're all heirloom seeds. I do not use any of that crap you buy at China Mart. It is called China Mart because 80-90% of the stuff that's in that store comes from China, and they've been proven so many times to be poisonous and unhealthy for you. But you know what? Good prices, cheap price, whatever. You get what you deserve. You pay for cheap shit, you're gonna get cheap shit, okay? But anyway, I have some peppers over here. I have cayenne peppers and red habanero peppers. I don't know if you can read that in there. Red habaneros. I used jalapenos in there last year or year before, 2 years ago. But now these are red habanero peppers I got from Solutions from Science. So solutionsfromscience.com if you want to get some decent seeds too. I mean, there are other sites too I've ordered from. I've got a lot of different seeds. Anyway, then I got five Wonder, called California Wonder Peppers. Like, they're bell peppers. And I'm thinking I have others in here, but I don't remember because I didn't write them down like I should have. I've got my other seeds started in these little pots that I can put out into the ground itself. These should be long green pod okra and burgundy okra. I'm going to remove these for a few moments to look at the rest of the things up here. They just started sprouting out the other day, and I mean, they're really starting to come up now, all of the seeds. But not all of the seeds, but majority of them. I put the cardboard thing on it. That's a sunflower seed in the front left corner there. I'm going to zoom in on it. That's a sunflower. Then I've got, next to it should be, is another sunflower. Then two in the middle, both planters have, let me see if I can read that. I got a little card down there. Sunflower. Then I've got cherry tomatoes in those two planters, both of those planters. I had put two seeds in each one, I thought, but that planter there on the right, let me move this back a little bit so you can see a little. There's three in there growing. Now, that's, I don't know, two seeds and three tomato plants. And, I mean, I'm quite sure I didn't drop three seeds in there, you know. But anyway, there's three in this one, too, here. But these are, which ones are those? Those are Rutgers, R-U-T-G-E-R, tomatoes. And then, like I said, I put two seeds in each planter. Three in that one, and three in that one, and one in that one there. There should be another one coming out of that one. But again, I don't know why three are coming out the other two planters. And then the last one back are Mariglobe tomatoes. They're not popping up just yet. This morning I just noticed, if I can get it into it right there, oh, there it is. That right there, okay, focus, focus, focus! It's a black eyed pea. Let's zoom out. There's a black eyed pea in that one. That one and that one, all planted the same day. So you see how that one's coming up, and these two other two aren't yet. That one there, there are two pepper seeds in that, that and that. Again, the peppers are, I can't recall if they were cayenne or not, but those are in there. And I have a planter at the bottom down here. I'll pause this and bring it up here. Hold on, pause. Okay, that's the planter that was on the shelf below down there. Okay, and this one here, I have aroma bean on the left side of the planter. Then I have three, let me see if I can see it. Romanesco artichoke in the middle, and then three yellow peppers, one of the yellow peppers, which are, again, are like a bell pepper, on the right of this planter. I'm going to get up closer here. I don't think anything's coming through. I just planted those about 4 days ago, maybe. And, let's see what we can find in there. Nothing's growing up here. I wouldn't expect that for another couple days yet. But, I mean, plus I have other planters. I'll show you here. I'm going to pause this again and miraculously start it again. You'll be looking at a different picture completely. But, I mean, you got to get your garden started. I'm trying to get this all started out for survival, actually, more than anything else. So hold on a second. Okay, magically, there you go. These are more than I've ever had before when I started this a couple years ago and had some pretty good turnouts. My mom passed away in December, and last year we didn't have a garden. She had cancer, and we just didn't do anything last year. We were planting seed. These are all heirloom seeds. There's a packet right there in that manila colored envelope, and packets that's sitting on top of it. Let me zoom in a little bit so you can see. You know, I put them in a plastic bag, a bunch of them that I planted a couple years ago, and kept them in the freezer. I keep mine in the freezer. They last about 7-8 years in a cool, dry environment. In the freezer, they'll last you, or not last, but they'll be most potent, I guess you'd say. Seeds last forever, just about. But I keep mine in the freezer, deep freezer. And I just got these some solutions from Science when I ordered some items from them. And I have a bunch in there that I'm planting. I think that last one, that top one there is an artichoke. If I'm not mistaken, I can't really make it out good. Anyway, solutions from Science. They sent me some seeds there. See, this little tray thing I got at China Mart, which is the actual name of the place is China Mart. Regardless of what you say, funny or not, stupid or not, China Mart, 93%+ of everything in that store is from China and is shabby quality. If you want cheap stuff, you deserve to have cheap stuff, and it will break and you'll have to get it again and again and again and again, because you can. Well, in the near future, even cheap stuff's going to be kind of unaffordable for a lot of people. So I bought that tray there and those biodegradable planters, which I put right in the ground. I had those over there. I showed you at the other place. More planters there, a couple bottles I use for water. To filter it, I use it with the filter. I'm using that gallon and pour it in two at a time to filter it out. This comes from a seed, one of the seed places, gettheseeds.com, I believe, but that was like 3 years ago, 4 years ago. It gives you the average first and last frosts for your area in the country, or I think North America for that matter. Because according to Bush, that criminal that was in the White House before this criminal, he signed a North American agreement saying that Canada, the United States, and Mexico are North America. And that's what they're going by. It's all lies. It's all bullshit. But, you know, you don't care. So, you know, it is as far as they're concerned. Then it gives you a guide here, a slide, where you can match up your first or last frost dates. And then what needs to be planted when inside, or if you plant it in a pot inside first and then take it outside. You know, that's the things. There's a couple of different things for the other. I think that's the fall. The spring is on the other side. You flip it over, and same deal where you line up that red stripe with the date of the first, the last frost for the spring. And then you match it for when you should plant inside. Gives you the rows, seed inside, last plant, and then when you harvest them. Okay. And a little basic guidelines to help you get by. Don't worry about it. See, average frost, last fall, first frost for fall. So, like I said, it's pretty good. It's a helpful little thing to have. But, you know, that's the seeds to get yourself started. I would recommend Solutions from Science, but like I said, there are a lot out there. Alex Jones has them on the InfoWars site. We can get heirloom seeds, folks. The crap you buy at China Mart is genetically modified, you know. And a lot of people if they laugh or giggle about it, they're stupid. I'm sorry, but that's the honest to God truth. If you giggle over something you don't know about, that's a sign of stupidity, actually. You're foolish. You know, whatever. But get some heirloom seeds. Heirloom seeds. Don't go to China Mart. I mean, a lot of the nurseries even around here, they sell crap. It's all been genetically modified. They're better than the stuff you'll get at a big chain, because a big chain is in the business to make money. They don't give a shit about your health, no matter what they tell you. It's not like that anymore. We're not in Kansas anymore, Dorothy. So remember that. Make a little effort if you want to be healthy. If you don't have a lot of space and you don't have no place really to have a garden, have some big pots. I've got some out on the porch, you know, big ones. Plus those two I showed you over by my other plants. I've been fortunate enough to have a place where I have a little bit of a space to have a garden, which I've shown on here before. When it gets down and the proverbial shit hits the fan, I've tried to tell people and teach them as best I can. I'm going to pause this. It'll just go over 10 minutes. I'm going to stop it and I'll start a second video so you'll know it's coming behind this one. This will be part one. I'm going to stop it.